Bristol Bay, east of Togiak. The Time Bandits' tanks are filled with 90,000 kilos of herring.
We take that to the cannery and they get to stay on the ground, so we give them water and food. They never have to leave. Us big boats run back and forth from the canneries. That's our job.
And maintain a constant temperature for the trip to the floating processor.
It's a big vacuum. They suck our fish out with a vacuum, basically.
The processor pumps the herring from the Time Bandits' tank right to the assembly line, where they are sorted, stacked, frozen, and shipped to Japan. It's only been an hour since Dan took over as captain.
There they are.
But quickly, he runs into problems.
Hey, we're wondering if you got time for a quick crew member check.
Alaska State Troopers board the Infinite Glory.
Okay, who's the skipper, you?
Yeah, skipper.
How long have you been commercial fishing for?
About a day.
Do you have your ADF&G permit and your Coast Guard documentation?
I'm sure it's somewhere.
Yeah, climb out there and look and tell me if it's blue, because it should be red.
Yeah, it's blue.
Yeah, do you have the red one? Usually they come attached to this paperwork right here. Give her a quick once-over and see if you can't find her real quick, because that's a citation, actually.
But does it have to be displayed, or what's the story?
It's got to be displayed. The fishery's in progress right now, and you guys are loaded with nets on the back of the boat, and so... You know, our understanding is that you're commercial fishing.
Yeah.
And you gotta have that sticker on there before you guys do that.
I don't know where it is.
I'm gonna write you a citation for a number plate requirement. Okay, here's your ID back. What I need for you to do is sign right here. It's not saying you're guilty, it's not saying you're innocent, it's just saying that you received the citation.
The citation will cost the rookie skipper hundreds of dollars. Daniel Stafford, the Infinite Glory's 19-year-old captain, is ready for his first set.
You never hear of a story like that where a 19-year-old kid gets $1.5 million sane boat. He's sweating bullets right now. But this kid's just got handed the holy grail, man. Anybody can set a sane, but try to get it back.
Knowing
and keeping
to hold the fish in there and hold the shape,
yeah,
and win the purse.
The shape, keeping that shape. It's an art, it's a fine art.
The entire fishery is watching to see how the young skipper handles the heat. As the Infinite Glory searches from the water, the spotter plane returns and begins searching from above. The pilot spots a school.
Yeah, what do you think, Jimmy? Should I sit here?
Should be all right there.
Danny gives his first order, and the skiff races out to circle the school with the net.
There you go, come right, Pete. They're going to lead right into the belly.
See what we got here.
They get the net around the fish, but when the skiff returns to hand the lead line off to the Infinite Glory, the line gets snagged and won't release.
What happened?
Oh, damn!
He's losing his set.
Right now you can go set right on top.
Come on!
The small mistake has caused a major tangle, costing them a $9,000 set.
The leads got balled up, and we don't have any fish in there anyway, so what fish are in there we're gonna let go and just get the net back and go for another set.
man's first catch.
With a target of 850 tons for the season, they need to quickly reset. Within minutes, the pilot sets them out on another school. But as the skiff heads out, the net stays on the boat.
It's like the skiff moving up and then we go from that one.
Hey Matt, just hook back up to the boat.
The skiff line wasn't hooked in and came undone, costing them a 70-ton set, another $9,000, and a ton of pride.
He just didn't have it hooked up. Now this guy got the set.
Oh man, that's so s**t up. I've had that happen before.
You man, would be proud.
At Nunavachik Bay with the Sainer boats.
Yeah, Roger.
After losing two big sets, young Dan and the Infinite Glory are tracking a biomass near the rocks.
Found another school, so we're good to go.
Looks like he's gonna make a set right here. Get him in right on the rocks.
The skiff heads out to corral a large school. Captain Danny needs to land some fish before Dad gets back.
It's the plan, man.
Everything looks good so far, but we are sitting pretty shallow right now. So the net's definitely sitting resting on the bottom, and that's normally a recipe for disaster.
It's go time, boys!
Yeah, we hope there's some herring in here. We'll see, though. I don't know, we got them kind of shallow.
We're first up, we got the fish.
I'm gonna pull it up a little bit.
But as they bring up the net, there's a problem.
Snagged up a little here.
Oh no, don't do it.
Their net is caught on the rocky bottom and could rip, costing them thousands of dollars and ending their season.
Might as well do this on time lapse.
What should take minutes is taking hours.
Can you see what's going on?
Yeah.
Sort of doesn't sound too promising at this time.
They go late into the night.
This sucks. It's like midnight right now, still out here, dealing with the same nightmare, so it's starting to get old.
5 hours after their set started, the nightmare finally ends.
Still friends. Dan held the pressure like a man?
Kinda. I was stressed out. But we got it back. Let's go anchor up and
the net's still on board.
Have some tea and strumpets.